Hi, my name is Chuck Winter, and I'm going to give you a brief overview of atomic layer deposition, just so you understand the chemistry that is involved and what features can be obtained by atomic layer deposition growth. In the top, in blue and red, you take chemical reactant A and chemical reactant B, and the chemistry of these precursors is designed so that they react rapidly in an ALD reactor to give material C. And then what we do is we transfer this chemistry to an ALD reactor. We place a substrate, which might be a piece of glass, it might be a piece of silicon wafer, or it might be a computer chip that's undergoing manufacturing. And in the first step, what we do is we take a bare substrate and treat it with reactant A in blue. And the key feature of ALD is that we form a monolayer of A on the surface of the substrate. And we don't form multi-layers, just monolayers. And then this monolayer in a subsequent step is treated with reactant B, which is designed to react with reactant A to give material C. So the reactant B forms a monolayer on top of the monolayer of A, and these then react rapidly together chemically to give a film of C, which is shown on the right. And this is the key step in atomic layer, key sequence of steps in atomic layer deposition, is the formation of this monolayer of the desired film C. And then we can repeat this sequence of A plus B many times to achieve a thicker film of C, and in fact, the thickness of the overall film can be controlled by the number of times that you repeat the cycle. Now, some features of ALD, I've already explained the growth from monolayers, and this is called self-limited growth, and I'm not going to talk about the chemistry of self-limited growth, but it is controlled by chemistry. And the second feature is that we have the ability to control film thicknesses at the atom level. So if we wanted to make a film that had five layers of atoms in it, we could do that very precisely using ALD. And then finally, another feature of ALD is that because of the chemistry control in the process, we can deposit very conformal films in narrow and deep features. And I show in the middle lower right the formation of a uniform thickness film of a hypothetical material in a feature where it's deeper than it is wide. And the chemistry and the monolayer growth mechanism of ALD allows this to happen. So this is an overview of ALD. Thank you.